Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be talking about the possibility of Tapion and Bardock coming along with the Dokkan Awakening of Ultra Instinct Goku. So first off, last week I was on that motorcycle trip that I told you all I was going to go on. I was gone on Tuesday and Wednesday all day. I didn't get home till like midnight on Wednesday. I think I ended up riding 16 and a half hours straight from the time that I left the hotel on Tuesday or on Wednesday morning. Left at like 8 a.m. I didn't get home till after midnight. I was riding around, went all the way to North Vermont. I checked out Lake Eden, and I was riding around all up there, and then a rainstorm started coming, so I tried to outrun it, and I was able to. I got lucky. But man, let me tell you what a pain in the butt that ride was. I was really doing the trip more to see how long I could actually stand sitting on a bike and riding around for, and 16 hours definitely pushed it. I think a limit of like 6 to 8 hours would probably be good, maybe 10 if I need to push, like, getting somewhere fast. Obviously, I could do more than that now, and I know that I could do more than that now. But, yeah, that's a thing. So, I had a lot of fun doing that, and that's the reason why I did not jump onto... I was going to jump onto a live stream on Thursday, if you weren't aware. I was so exhausted, I slept for, like, 9 hours that Thursday. And I woke up, and I tried to move around. The lactic acid in my body was so built up. Like, I just did a couple things, and I laid down most of the day, and I slept. I took so many naps. Then I started working again the next day. So apologies if those of you were looking for some videos. I really did want to get them out to you, but I was just so exhausted. I was kind of debating on bringing my laptop with me, but as you all know, the laptop's garbage, and trying to make it not overheat when rendering videos and everything, it's too much work. So maybe if one day I get a better laptop, I'll be able to record on the go. Anyway, we are here because we're going to be talking about the new Dokkan Awakenings, or the potential information that can be coming soon on May 16th. I know a lot of you are aware, if you've been checking out tweets and everything, there's supposed to be information about the Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku medals available. There's information about Super Saiyan 3 Bardock coming. There's information about Tapion coming. So I'm kind of excited, because if we get all this, that means we are so close to catching up with JP, which means we're like literally around the corner. So, I mean, I know I did this with you guys the other day. In terms of summons, we just had the Rose and the Vegito Blue banners. We have the World Tournament banner stuff out right now. Other than that, I mean, we just have all the basic banners that have been out. The Super Saiyan 3 Broly, or the Super Saiyan Broly, Extreme Dokkan Awakening, Extreme Z Awakening. We had the LR Bojack that has come out, the 1000 Day Celebration. Obviously, all the banners, the Monotype banners, the Super Saiyan 3 Extreme Z Awakening, the Revival Frieza. And if you go over here and you look at this is the JP side. Now, I went back pretty far to the Kefla banner, which we already got, the Super Vegito banner, which we got. We have gotten this, the Super Saiyan 3 Goku Extreme Z Awakening. We're probably not going to get Heroes. The Bardock banner is what we're supposed to be getting. Now, again, this is just potential information. There's nothing official confirming this. This is just, I guess, stuff that was found in the database, but it's not like anything was translated or uploaded to the database as an official release date. This is just stuff that I guess was updated with this information. So if this is true, I don't understand why they're doing all three at one time. That doesn't make any sense to me personally. But whatever, if they do all three at one time or not, maybe it's just all three of them are going to be launched within a special. So maybe we're going to get some type of bonus special that's going on for like springtime, something like that, where they're going to be like, all right, we're doing a double Dokkan Fest or triple Dokkan Fest, you know, and it's going to last a month, month and a half, and every 2 weeks a new banner comes out. Maybe something like that's going to happen. Who knows? We're going to find out. But the Bardock banner is one that I'm super excited about. I could definitely use a dupe of the Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku, and I do not have Revived Frieza, which would be pretty cool because I do have a pretty OP team for the Revival Saga, especially if I get Bardock. That would just make it really awesome. So I'm most likely going to be something on this banner. I kind of really hope it doesn't. I hope Tapion comes out first because I'm not pulling on that banner. I would really like to conserve some things, you know, just to, you know, be a little bit nicer. But other than that, I mean, it's not a big deal. With that, we're probably going to get the Super Saiyan 3 banner along with it. So you're going to get the ability to pull any of the Super Saiyan 3s. Again, I already have most of them, so I don't really need... I mean, I think I have all of them, actually. So I don't really need any dupes because I'm probably not going to feed any dupes. Maybe the Vegeta, because this Strength GT Vegeta is really good when you have them duped out. Really good tank, actually, as well. But we'll talk about that when it becomes available. I'd be pretty excited when this comes out. So we're at the hold off. The other one's a Tapion banner. We got this special. It looks like it was a double SSR rate. So, I mean, it's up to you if you want to pawn that or not. I personally am not. I'm not a big fan of a huge category lead. I mean, he's not a bad unit by any means. I just would, you know, I'll get him at a different time. You know, like, that's just my thing. I mean, Tapion's cool and whatnot. And Harutagon's pretty cool. But, I mean, I'm not going to go hard for him just because the banner wasn't really that great. I mean, we'll go take a look over here if it wants to load. I wasn't a big fan of the banner that they threw the characters in. I mean, the only one that I really want is this freaking Goku over here. And that's just because I don't have him. I don't have this Super Saiyan Goku. I have all of the crossover Gokus. I have 9 of them left. Literally, specifically waiting for him. I grinded out every single one. I grinded out so many of those Gokus just so that way I never had to use Elder Kais on these guys to get them up to Super Attack 10. There's 9 of them waiting for this guy. I really want him. And oh my gosh, when I get him, that's gonna be great. So I don't know. I'm not gonna pull on it though for him specifically. So unless they change up the banner, I'm probably not gonna be pulling on that one. I would make the same recommendation for you guys unless you really like the transformations. It looks like you get the Santa. Well, this came out around Christmas time, so they might do just Elder Kais for us. If they don't, it'll probably just be maybe a double rates banner. Who knows? We'll have to wait and find out. If it's double rates, maybe I'll do 1 or 2 summons if we get some discount stones. But again, I'm really trying to save for the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock. Outside of that, I mean, we already got the Broly Extreme Z Awakening, we got the Rose, we got the Super Vegito, we got the Elder Kai stuff that already came out. Tapion came back with another banner. Then we had some other characters over here that were, you know, just, I forgot what the heck this one was actually for. I think it was just like an extreme discount summons for good units. Maybe it was for pure Saiyans, because it looks like it was all the Saiyans in here, who knows. Then we had the LR Goku and Vegeta banners for the third year. Now, our third year is in 2 months, right? So our third year is supposed to be right around the corner. When that comes out, we should be having the LR Goku and Vegeta units. Now, I also want to save up for that. And these are pretty fun banners. They have really good units coming out on them. I know I discussed this with you guys in the last time I did this video. The top 4 over here are on both banners, and then other than the new units, all these guys are old Dokkan Fest exclusives. Personally, I need the Gogeta. I would like another Janemba for dupe, another Gogeta for dupe, obviously. But I don't know which one I want personally. I really like the physical one, and I also like the intelligence one. The intelligence banner has Super Vegito Kid Buu and this Super Saiyan Blue Vegito. To really go based off of what you have. Now, personally, in terms of which ones I want, I mean, I've played with the intelligence one. He's definitely a lot of fun to play with. But my Super Vegito, Jelly one, my Vegito Blue physical one, and my Intelligence Kid Buu are all 100% it. And these guys up top aren't awesome, in my opinion. Really not. So I'm probably going to end up going on the physical banner, just because it's probably going to be a little bit more worth it for me to go up and get these guys. I mean, I don't need it for my team. My team's pretty OP as it is. So we'll see what happens. Plus, I don't have the Intelligence Gogeta at all. And Janemba and Tech Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta are not maxed out, even though these guys are maxed out on the bottom. I have more people who are 120 or category leads on this banner that I don't have. So I'm probably just going to be going ham on this one. But that's my personal thing. That's how you should be basing off of what you're going to be going if you guys are going to be saving for those banners. Again, my opinion. I know we talked about this a couple weeks ago. So keep that in mind. But outside of that, I mean, we're pretty much caught up. Everything else has come. We for the third year anniversary, you're probably going to get all the individual LR banners, the featured units. And then this is the Ultra Instinct banner with the new Jiren. So if that does come out on the 15th, we're going to be caught up with that. That's what we're going to be having. And then I think the only thing left would be the Turles. Yeah, it would be the Turles with the boss category, at least at this time. Because I'm pretty sure that's all we have left to catch up with them with. Oh, and the Vegeta Blue for that. So right now, they're only ahead of us by 2 banners, technically. Oh, actually, we also have the ones that haven't come out yet. But those are the ones that have been released that we know are not on the roadmap as of right now. So what I'm thinking that's going to happen is I think we are going to get the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock banner and the Tapion banner. Maybe they're going to give us both at the same time. And the reason I think that is because this came out for Christmas and they gave us Santa Roshis and everything and they can't give us the same deals. So they might just give us both banners at the same time. The other method that I think that they can do. Oh, then they will probably do the Tournament of Power after that. The other thing I think they could do is they can make it a special festival. So maybe two months leading up to the third year anniversary, where they release one for every like 2.5 weeks, they release another banner. If that's the case, I'd be more okay with that. I would not want both of these released at the same time. I would personally, I mean, it looks like these were released within a week of each other anyway. So that's just my personal opinion and preference on it. But either way, we should be getting these soon. We don't know what's next, and because the only ones that are next are either going to be Tapion, Super Saiyan 3 Bardock, or Ultra Instinct Goku, unless they decide to give us Vegito Blue, but I feel like they would need to do the Tournament of Power ones first, because you need Ultra Instinct Goku. I'm pretty sure Ultra Instinct Goku came before Vegito Blue Evolution. Anyway, if that spinner comes out also, that's going to be a little bit of a crutch for me, because I really want to pull on this too, because the Jiren is so awesome. Kefla would be good to get Dokkan. I don't have the Ultra Instinct Goku. The Tech Android 18 is actually pretty good. I don't have the Frieza. And, I mean, the other two are horrible, so I would like to get more of them for dupes. That would be such an epic banner. So we'll have to wait and see what happens, and hopefully we get what we want. In terms of information, we do know that the Ultra Instinct Goku medals are here. So that's kind of like giving us a little push towards, hey, this is probably going to happen soon. Again, that's in 10 days from now. Also, the World Tournament is on, so I know I'm going to go moving off of that topic right now. This video is about. The World Tournament is on, so I am only going for the rewards. I don't even know if I'm going to be able to complete all of them. I got my 20 wins. I died on like 11 because I thought I used my Ghost Usher, and I did not. I used an Orb Changer. So I ended up getting knocked out in my semifinals when I was 11 on 11 win streak. So now I've done like 20 wins total, or 21 wins total, something like that. And I've almost got my 30 million points. Actually, no, I'm only halfway to 30 million. So the rest of today and tomorrow is going to be me grinding out to get to those 30 million points. And most likely by the time I get the 30 million points, I'm going to end up having all 20 consecutive wins. So we'll see what happens with that. I am not really going for that Trunks though. I kind of want to, because I know when he gets a Dokkan Awakening, he's probably going to be pretty damn epic. I could see him doing like attack plus 100% or 90% and then key plus 2 or 3 for himself, something like that, something ridiculous. So I kind of want to get him because of that, but at the same time, even if I do, my team is so OP on both versions, I'm probably never going to run him, unless there's a specific event where he's going to become very useful, which typically does happen. Some World Tournament cards do become very useful. Either way, I have a whole bunch of guaranteed SSR tickets that I've been saving. I did a couple last night. I did two last night, actually, just because I needed some, like, you know, some guaranteed luck over here. And I ended up pulling the Tech Super Saiyan 2 Gohan from the World Tournament rewards. And I was very happy because I did not have him. I really wanted him. So he was one of them. Him and the Bardock were the two that I really wanted. I don't have the Bardock, but I did get the one Gohan. So when he gets his Dokkan Awakening, I'm going to be super freaking happy. I'll talk about the Gohan's Dokkan Awakening, because there's some epic stuff about him, but it's like one of those things where it's kind of like, it can be very epic, but it's not really worth it. But he's pretty cool. He's a good unit. He's a good support unit as well. So we'll be talking about that. And then, yeah, I think pretty sure that's all that there is that I want to go over here. So let me know what you guys are hyped for. Personally, I would like them to do the Tapion banner first to give us a little bit of a break, and then give us a Super Saiyan 3 Bardock banner, then follow that up with the UI banner. But they're probably going to give us Tapion and the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock banner at around the same time. Or they do the Bardock banner first, and then likely they did on JP, a week later do the Tapion. Towards the end of the Bardock, they'd release the Ultra Instinct Goku along with the first wave. And then they'd probably do the Super Vegeta Blue after that. They might put it on hold and do the 30 year anniversary by the time that that's all finished. And then they would probably do the final whatever actual event that they want to release, or the actual banner they want to release. I don't know if we're going to get the Vegeta Blue Evolution right away or not, so we'll see. We'll have to see if that comes before or after the third year. But anyway, guys, that is it. Thank you for joining me here today. Again, let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. I'm kind of hyped for this. We'll see what happens. Thank you, guys. I'll catch you all later. Peace.